last week and a half has been a real, real rough ride for me and my family, especially my younger kids. Zachary, Jordana, Tia left. It's been difficult. And I still don't even know if there's words to express the amount of pain that we went through. And I've come to realize now that it wasn't just a family pain, a father pain, a mother pain, a brother or sister pain. It's a community pain.
Yes.
And one of the things that really struck me the most is to see that it takes a tragedy like this for us to come together. Still a loss for words, but the one thing I really want to say is that I don't know how we would have gotten through it without you guys.
Oh.
All the phone calls, the people that showed up at the house, the email, the messages inboxed, you know, just, it's been unbelievable. And it has somewhat cushioned our blows to know that we have people around us that care. Our family, my brother just left Afghanistan. He didn't even tell us he was coming. I haven't seen him in 7 years. And he showed up. Haven't seen him in 7 years. He has to leave tomorrow to go back to what we're dealing with here now. Death. Every day he sees it. But I do know one thing. The minute he got here, he never stopped crying. Shane was more than a son to me. He was one of my best friends. Of course, just like every other best friend, there's always gonna be some little something here and there, a little bump here and there. On the most part, I think everybody who knew him personally know that Shane was a good kid. He'd always listen. He never would tell you yeah, 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 and then go right ahead and did what you asked him not to do. The one thing that Shane really loved most was music, and you all know that. Very passionate, but then how could he not? Came from a line of music, you know. If anybody know my dad, Ricky, you could testify to that. That's Ricky Bowman. Remember Ricky Bowman, guys?
Yes.
Exodus. Ricky knows that music has always been our family. My oldest daughter Tia, she's this close to, well, she's already started to record. Zachary, he says his name is DJ Snowflakes. So, it's always been a part of our life, and if it's the one thing I know Shane would have wanted out of all of this, is for all of us to walk out of here with our heads high. Nobody should hold their head down. He always wanted to make everybody happy. That's Shane for you. To all his friends who've been to his parties, all he wanted to do was make that party better than the one yesterday. To make the next song that he's about to play better than the song he just played before, whatever it took. And again, I don't know if my mom wants to say anything. If she's around Joan, I don't know if you want to say anything. Zachary, you want to say anything?
Yeah, Zachary, can you say something? Come on, DJ Snowflake.
I think I'm speaking for everybody when I said, people, I thank you. We thank you so much for being there for us. And like I said, this journey has been one that is unimaginable, but I think what made it easy for us somewhat is that we had people like you guys here for us. So Shane is gone, but he will live on forever in our memories.
Amen.
And he would want all of us to do what we do to the very best of our ability. That's what he was like. You know, I remember whenever he sat down, Shane was just doing, he just started to do graphic designing, and whenever he sat down to do a flyer, I would do it in 20 minutes and it would take him 3 hours. Not that he didn't know what he was doing, because I always went to him to find out how to do it. He knew how to do it, but he just wanted to take the extra time to make sure what he was doing was done right. Make sure it was done to the best of his ability. I still question the last party Shane had. If anyone didn't know, Shane had a party that he was planning. The party happened last weekend. It was called Cloud 9. Now, I don't know if I or anyone in this room could have came up with a concept like that. Because Cloud 9 is supposed to be the highest cloud. And that's where I think Shane is right now. Maybe I should have been more attentive and listened to him because maybe he was sending me a message. But nevertheless, Shane is on Cloud 9. And I don't know if I would have wanted to be anywhere else right now. So again, thanks everyone. I think I'm speaking on behalf of the family, all of our close friends, all of his friends. This support network has to continue. I don't want it to be every time we lose something that we come together to try to find something. You know, if you have a friend here that you haven't seen in years, get their number. Call them tomorrow, call them next week. Don't wait until you hear that friend has something that, you know, you think you should call to let them know you're still there. I don't want to take up too much time. And I just want everybody again to know how appreciative me and my family are for having everyone here. And you guys deserve to give yourself a big, big round of applause. And don't take it lightly. We have to stay together. We have to. I've seen people here that I haven't seen in 10 years. Let's make it a week at the max. Everybody agree with me?
Yes.
All right. Once again, thank you guys very much. And Shane, wherever you are, you know that we love you. And I told you yesterday before I left the funeral home, anytime you want to come home, I'm here. I'm here. We're here.
Talking to me when it comes on. Another day, another dawn. Another Keisha, nice to meet you. Get the math, I'm gone. What am I supposed to do when the club lights come on? It's easy to be puffed with his heart.